Good morning, children. Welcome back to English Online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. I hope you all are doing great and staying safe at home. Yes? Okay, then let's start our today's session. We are discussing lesson 6, verbs from our grammar text. We have already discussed what are verbs and also the family tree of tenses. Even though we haven't completed the family tree, today we will complete the family tree by discussing future tense. So today we'll discuss future tense and also the uses of have, has and had. I hope you understood the topics that we had discussed in previous classes, present tense and past tense. Children, you have to be thorough with those two tenses. Okay? Now children, what do you mean by future? Future is something that might happen at a later time. And we can express a future action through several ways. But today we'll discuss the four ways of expressing a future action. Let's see those four ways. The first way to express a future action is we can use shall or will. We can use modal auxiliaries like shall or will. You have already studied what is a modal auxiliary, right? In lesson 4 at the games, shall or will is used to predict an action taking place at a later time. So we can use shall with the first person, that is I and we. We use will with second and third persons. Which are the second and third person? It is second person is you and third person is he, she, it and they. So with you, he, she, it and they we can use will, and with I and we can use shall. For example, they will be here in a couple of hours. Suppose I have invited some of my friends. So I am telling to my parents that they will be here in a couple of hours. Then I shall meet her if I have time. So with I have used shall, and with they I have used will. Both this will and shall is used to predict about future, to make predictions. Predictions means to say something that will happen at a later time. Okay, now let's move to the second way of expressing a future action. We can use present continuous tense. I hope you remember what is a present continuous tense, right? The form of present continuous tenses, we can use subject plus is or am or are plus verb plus ing. So what is the form of present continuous tense? It is or am or are plus verb plus ing. For example, she is reading a book. Here, which is the present continuous tense? It is reading. Is plus verb plus ing form. We make use of present continuous tense to denote a future action, to mention about or to talk about people's plans or arrangements. For example, a friend of mine is coming for lunch tomorrow. Here, which is the present continuous tense? It is coming. The union leaders are meeting the chief minister at 9 o'clock tonight. So here, which is this present continuous tense? Are meeting. Next, another example. Our team is playing the final of the cricket tournament on Sunday. So here, is playing is a present continuous tense. So sometimes we make use of present continuous tense in order to express a future action, to tell about people's plans or arrangements. We may make several plans or arrangements to lead a future life, right? The third way of expressing a future action is we can make use of the phrase going to. If we make use of going to, we can express a future action. For example, he fears that the examination is going to be tough. It seems as if it is going to rain. See, I have made use of going to in order to express a future action. Okay? Now let's see the fourth way of expressing a future action. We can make use of simple present tense in order to denote a future action. So let's see some examples. The school reopens on June 1st. Schools reopen on June 1st. The IPL cricket matches commence on next Sunday. We leave at 4 p.m. tomorrow. So here, leave is a present tense, simple present tense. And in case of second sentence, the IPL cricket matches commence on next Sunday. Here, commence is a simple present tense. And in the first sentence, schools reopen on June 1st. Here, reopen is a simple present tense. So I hope you understood which are the four ways of expressing a future action. I hope it is clear to you. Now let's move to the topic uses of have, has and had. Have and has is used in present tense, whereas had is used in past tense. In order to denote a past activity, we use had. So in present tense, we can make use of have and has. Okay, that is the first usage. Then next, we can use have with plural pronouns or with plural subjects. Plural pronouns like I, you, we, they, we can use have. With I, we, you and they, we can use have, or with plural subjects. For example, the boys have a cricket match today. As the boys are the plural subject, I made use of have. Next, has is used with singular subject or singular pronouns. It's like he, she and it. The boy has a drawing competition today. See, as I am referring to a single boy, I made use of only has. Next, had is used with past tense in order to denote a past action. For example, the boys had a cricket match yesterday. So that action is already over, so I made use of had. We can use had with all the pronouns. Like we can use had with I also. With the plural pronouns also, we can make use of had. I had my breakfast. Next, have or has is used for activities that completed recently. Completed recently means that completed just a short time ago. It just happened now. For example, she has arrived from school. Another example, I have bought a new car. All these actions just happened now. It is already completed. All these actions just happened recently. Another example, I have finished my homework. So this action also completed recently, just a short time ago. My friend has completed the painting. It means that action has just completed recently. Had is used in order to describe an action or denote an action that happened at a particular time in the past. That happened at a certain time in the past. For example, when I reached the station, the train had left. When the police arrived, the thief had escaped. So all these actions just happened at a particular moment in the past. When we want to mention a particular time in the past, we can make use of had. So I hope you understood the usages of have, has and had. So children, try to complete the textual exercises. So children, I hope you understood today's topic clearly. Now let me discuss the textual exercises given in your text. At last, you have an integrated grammar exercise. In that you have exercise A and exercise B. In exercise A, you have two sets of questions. In that two sets of questions, there is a missing word in each line. You have to find out that missing word and write in the space provided. So when you write that missing word, you have to write the word that comes before and after that word. Okay? Not only the middle word, but you have to write the word that comes before and after it. And in exercise B, they have given two passages. In the two passages, there are errors in each line. So you have to identify that errors and write the correct one. So children, I hope you understood today's topic clearly. And it's time to wind up our session. So let's conclude our session here. That's all for today. See you in the next class.